Marijuana, the dried leaves and flowers of the Indian hempweed, is used in the form of a cigarette. Should you ever be confronted with the temptation of taking that first puff of a marijuana cigarette, do it.
Hey guys, it's me, Wiggum Manorino. How are you today? Okay guys, let's talk about a few things today. One is this. I believe that those institutions out there, for example, JP Morgan, in direct collusion with the CME group, and this is no secret, we understand. Hey guys, it's me, Gregory Manorino. How are you today? Okay guys, what do we know? Well, a lot of stuff going on. We just found out that the leaders in Europe have gotten together over this two-day meeting, and apparently they came up with some ideas. One of them was this. They're going to be using some of their bailout funds to recapitalize the banks, because the banks are running out of money. Okay, well, I guess the good news in all this is, they're not going to be printing extra money to recapitalize these banks. They're just going to be taking it from some of the bailout money, which was printed out of thin air, as we know. Hi everybody, it's me, Greg Manorino. How are you today? Alright guys, I want to talk about how I believe that the mainstream media now is starting to come on board with some of these issues that people, unfortunately, you know, have to kind of search for. I think what's going on here is these media outlets, honestly, they're aware, I think, for the most part, of what's going on. Especially those that, you know, actually go out there and do the research. Not necessarily the ones that are reporting it. You know, these people are literally just fed information. They said, okay, talk about this. I'm talking about the people that actually are out there and trying to gather information. I don't believe that this can be ignored anymore. I mean, we understand that we're at a critical juncture. There is no doubt about it. More and more people are starting to talk about it. Even these kind, believe it or not. Hey guys, it's me, Gregory Manorino. How are you today? Alright guys, so what happened? Well, yesterday, we got to see the market plummet 251 points. We got to see precious metals also take a hit. Now, for those of you out there that follow this blog on a daily basis, none of this was a surprise to you. You all knew that this was coming. What else did you know? Well, we just found out that 15 of the world's largest banks were downgraded. Is that a surprise to you? Nope. Hey everybody, it's me, Greg Manorino. How are you today? Alright guys, we have a lot of information to go over today. I made a whole bunch of charts up for you. Now this is a suggestion for you. If you're new to this blog, or even if you watch this every day, I would suggest you either rewatch, or if you're again here for the first time, watch these other videos first, or again before moving forward with this one, because I'm going to cover a lot of things today. The videos I would suggest you watch prior to watching this one would be one that I did on June 12th titled Alert, X Wave Phenomenon, Major Financial Event. One I did on June 14th titled Stock Market Overvalued, Crash Coming. One I did on June 19th titled Cracks in the Bond Market Bubble. And the one I did yesterday titled Big Moves for Gold and Silver Coming. Now, I know that's a lot of stuff to go over. However,
marijuana, the dried leaves and flowers of the Indian hemp weed, is used in the form of a cigarette. Should you ever be confronted with the temptation of taking that first puff of a marijuana cigarette, do it.
Hi everybody, it's me, Greg Manarino. How are you today? Alright guys, more corruption in the banking and finance sector. That's all we hear about lately. We just found out that apparently Barclays, one of the biggest banks in the world, is apparently involved in a scandal with LIBOR. LIBOR stands for the London Interbanking Offered Rate. The story is this. Apparently, hey guys, it's me, Greg Manarino. How are you today? Alright guys, we're going to talk about the dollar and the euro today. In fact, I'm going to show you a couple of charts I made because I do believe that a picture is worth a thousand words. And these particular charts, I think, are very telling. Now, I understand that there are some people out there that don't get it. They don't understand what's going on. And I'm probably going to take some heat for this video in one way or the other. And that's okay. I'm an American citizen, as most of you know out there. And believe me, it pains me to have to sit here and try to make it clear to people that the United States, unfortunately, very unfortunately, is in a downward spiral.
What's up, people? The prophet of profit, and for those who get insulted, the Jesus Christ of Wall Street. How about that? I said it, yeah. You get insulted? Well, guess what? This video is going to probably insult one person very, very specifically, because I had to get in on the frenzy on this. Wait, hang on. Let me just let the illuminescence glow around me. Oh, yes. Now feel me, Greg Mananiro. Feel me, because I've got a proposition that could even be better than you wanting to get paid so people would leave you alone. That is the greatest marketing ploy I ever heard. I'm so sad because people disagree with me that now I need to charge people so nobody disagrees with me. Is that the concept there, Greg? I just want to say thank you to Tacos Mananiro's for illuminating this circumstance to my attention. Of course, the news unit, which I found, was the first person to bring this to my attention. Yes, thank you very much. So here's my proposition, Greg. Again, you're one of the only people that I do watch on YouTube because I get such a kick out of you how serious you are. And what's more intriguing to me is the nudniks that follow you. Now, again, we've had our differences in the past and I've called you out a number of times, wanted to just have a simple debate with you. You couldn't even respond. I just wanted to do a simple interview to get an idea of what you were thinking from week to week. You couldn't even respond. I just wanted to have just a back and forth. Let's see what you're thinking today, so we know, more importantly, what you're thinking to do in the stock market that day. All you do is you post a long and a short on your website, and that's it. What exactly does that mean? I'm thinking about buying it. I own it. What price? I'm short this. You've been telling people to buy gold and silver. You've got to admit defeat here, guy. So here's my proposition, because I'm going to keep this video short and sweet because, you know, a lot of people just, you know, you can't understand the Jesus Christ of Wall Street. So here it is, Greg. You got 25,000 subscribers, and you're a guy that's been getting it dead wrong. So apparently, the people out there on YouTube, you'd rather listen to a fear-mongering idiot. Let me digress. I don't want to call you an idiot, because I'm sure in your real life, you're doing something okay. I don't know you personally. I'm sure you're a fine gentleman. I don't know. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to call you. Again, the Jesus Christ of Wall Street shouldn't use words like idiot. Maybe you're just ignorant. Is that a better word? Because I've never seen, other than a few people that I've come across on Wall Street, somebody that can be as confident as you are, yet still getting it wrong. Each and every day, each and every video, what you say completely sort of makes sense, but yet the essence of it is always wrong. It is very, very hard to do, but you seem to pull it off. And for some reason, 24 or 25,000 people out there in the YouTube world think you're more important than a guy that's been getting it right since 2007. And Greg, when I was talking about shorting the market in 2007 and getting it wrong, guess what? I held out. I held out for the crash that I was predicting. And guess what? It happened and I made money. You've been talking about the crash that's coming for now 2-3 years. The dollar collapse, the gold and silver rally, the market that never goes down. And your defenders are always saying, oh, well, Greg does say to buy certain stocks. Does he? Does he really? He puts one thing on a list. I go out on a limb. I give you ideas. People are telling me I shouldn't even do these videos. But again, as the Jesus Christ of Wall Street, I feel compelled to go out there and help my fellow man, even though I am shunned in the YouTube community.
Paco's deleted your stuff. He's actually, well, you'll see. So he goes on to say, that guy connecting dots might be right about one thing. I pay for one-on-one sessions with Mike Status of Ava Investments Analytics, and Mr. Status worked at Bear Stearns. Okay, this is important, folks. I asked him about Mannarino, Gregory Mannarino, a while back. I didn't ask him if I could repeat this in public, but I doubt he will mind. Why? Because Mike Status, if you may have noticed in the comment section, is also another person who apparently who's been calling out these gold pumpers for a while. So him and I guess we have something in common. Now, what's important is that he said that he said he checked his old Bear Stearns employee directories and didn't see Mannarino in any of the directories. Mr. Status also said that there is no way Bear Stearns would hire him except as a janitor because he is too stupid. And if you don't know what I'm talking about stupid, hang on here. We're going to pull out one of Gregory's very first videos from 2012, and you have it listened to yourself, and you let me know if that guy doesn't sound stupid. You let me know if you can compare my voice compared to his, and I've just started learning a little bit of technical analysis, and I can talk about MACD and divergence and then, you know, stochastic RSI and price momentum, whatever. The fact is, he doesn't have the lingo, and he's dumb as a doornail. Unbelievable. And anyways, let's get on with that, because he also said it's impossible to begin a career at Bear Stearns because they don't have a training program. And that's what you'll see in this video I'm about to share with you. Had Gregory Mannarino actually been employed at Bear Stearns during the dot-com bubble, whatever, of 2008, he would have been speaking much better than he did has in that video from 2012 when he first made his appearance here on YouTube. So he, not only do we, you'll see for yourself, the guy, things don't add up. So you have to have the experience to work there. There's no doubt about it. Bear Stearns is not going to hire some drugged out dumbass. And I mean drugged out, as you can see here. How easy is it to claim you work somewhere that doesn't exist anymore? No one can verify your claims. A perfect con. Oh, and only physicians are allowed to claim they practice medicine. And that's interesting because that's one of the things that Gregory Mannarino says, that he's actually a medical practitioner. Oh, is that right, eh? Oh, wow. I imagine that's interesting because when I looked him up, he was a foot nurse. Yes, that's right. A foot nurse. He wasn't a doctor. He was a nurse that worked in a place where you go check your feet out. So the, whatever the nurse doctor, the nurse, whatever the foot doctors call, that's where Greg worked. Okay. So I'm going to his YouTube channel so you can see who this crooked son of a bitch is. Okay. Same with, look at the viewers, 27,000 subscribers. I don't believe that. And the reason why, and look at again here, there's your fraud squad. Ding, 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 ding. SGTReport.com, another one who promoted G4T. Anyways, the fraud squad, they hang out together, and I think many of you realize that, and YouTube does a hell of a good job promoting them and keeps us guy, like one of you guys said in the comments here, you know, are there any other truthers out there like yourself that aren't part of the circle jerk? Seems like all their voices are silenced or called crazy. Well, here's the silence part here, folks. Your related channels, they'll make sure that everyone that puts a financial video our YouTube channel, you're not going to be promoted here if you speak any truth. So don't expect to see the Silver Gold Man or Connecting Dots 2 here, Connecting Dots 3. They don't accept that. It's a circle jerk of corruption. And right down to his own damn YouTube channel, you can go read the shit. I can't believe it that he's allowed to keep this crap up. There you go. I'm not making this up, okay? Says I started my financial career working for the securities and trading arm of the now defunct Bear Stearns before the dot-com bubble. Ask him to pull out a couple of paycheck stubs. Ask him to provide you some evidence. He doesn't have any. I provided the evidence showing that he was an actual nurse. Nothing but a nurse. Not that there's anything against a nurse. Oh, there's a lot of pretty ones. Anyways, I don't mean to digress, but seriously, how can you come out and say that you worked at Bear Stearns and provide no evidence, and then you say, well, hold on a second there. I don't know if you caught that at the end. He says, I hold a medical degree and practice medicine. Oh, you practice medicine. Is that right, eh? A medical degree. Wow, imagine that. The guy got a medical degree, but he also started his financial career. Yeah, he's a doctor. He's not a doctor. He's a damn nurse. Oh, yeah, here's the best of it. He also, yeah, medical reserve. Yeah, holy jumping. Okay, so as I said, the circle jerk, they all promote each other. So you can see it right here, okay? Future money trends. If you guys want to know where the money's going, you better come here to Silver Gold Man, because I've got the long time show. Pete Santilli show, I just showed you a couple of days ago or a week ago how he was promoting Dabu 7. Actually, I don't even want to digress. Go back to my YouTube channel and you'll see how the Pete Santilli show, another New World Order agent here on YouTube, was promoting Dabu 7, telling folks to go listen to him, another guy, loser. So what's important? Let's continue on here because, you know, he goes on to say, I believe Marino was a pathological liar, a con artist, and a sociopath. I believe that also. And then he goes on to say, Mr. Status also told me some other things about Marino, but I don't want to talk about it here. But here's a hint. Have you ever wondered why his face looks so pale and weathered? Well, you know what? As I mentioned before, I'm a recovered drug addict, and that's the very first bloody thing I remember back in the day. If you're wondering how long I've been clean, it's over going on 12 years now. So yeah, back in the day when he first came out, Gregory Manarino, I looked at him. I'm like, whoa, 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 what the hell is this? A heroin addict? I figured he stuck on the down. It didn't look like he was a upper as in cocaine user. So does this guy look like the Bear Stearns type of, does he even look like a doctor? Can you see the black underneath his eyes? So I'm almost 100% sure here, this line here that he's talking about here at the very bottom. Very bottom of your screen there. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's what he's talking about. How Gregory looked like a drug addict and probably was. I'm not saying he still is, but definitely back then, Mr. had a drug problem. I can't prove that. Yes, absolutely. You're right. I can't prove that. So let's go look at his videos and you tell me if you think that this video sounds like a person who was trained. Holy jumping. Where's the video? No way. Oh, ho, ho. Hold on a second here. I was just out here yesterday, last night. Let's see here. Bingo. Time for action is now. Of course, because that's all he's ever done. It's always been the doomsday. Okay. Somebody says, can you get me unblocked? I don't know. You're not blocked. You're right there, Mike. Okay. Okay, everybody. We're going to listen to Gregory Manorino. Gregory, remember here, at this point here, okay, folks, he's been working at Bear Stearns during the dot-com bubble. You got to remember this. Gregory's been, even he's a pro here at this point. He's telling you that it's time for action. And you better listen to Gregory, because Gregory's got a long track record of bullshit. I mean, calling the markets out here on YouTube. But yeah, let's listen to Gregory. Okay, Greg, Mike, it's yours, buddy. Go ahead. Tell him. Go ahead, Mike. Go ahead.
I'm Greg Hunter. Welcome to the USA Watchdog YouTube channel. It supports USAWatchdog.com. I'm a former investigative correspondent. I worked on ABC's Good Morning America and also on CNN on many of their platforms. I try to put out interviews and information that is, above all, accurate. As my slogan on the website says, I try to give you a clear picture of what's really going on. I hope you enjoy the channel, and I hope you subscribe. Thanks again. I'm Greg Hunter.
There we go. Bingo. Time for action is now. Of course, because that's all he's ever done. It's always been the doomsday. Okay, somebody says, can you get me unblocked? I don't know. You're not blocked. You're right there, Mike. Okay. Okay, everybody. We're going to listen to Gregory Manorino. Gregory, remember here, at this point here, okay, folks, he's been working at Bear Stearns during the dot-com bubble. You got to remember this. Gregory's been, even he's a pro here at this point. He's telling you that it's time for action. And you better listen to Gregory, because Gregory's got a long track record of bullshit. I mean, calling the markets out here on YouTube. But yeah, let's listen to Gregory. Okay, Greg, Mike, it's yours, buddy. Go ahead. Tell him. Go ahead, Mike. Go ahead.
Manorino, how are you today? All right. For those of you that follow me, you might be wondering why this video is in black and white, and why I'm sitting here in a white T-shirt. We're going to talk about that in a minute. But this video today is a little different than my usual ones, I suppose, in that there is so much going on right now, yet it all boils down to one thing. What is that one thing? Okay. There was a gentleman named Ronnie James Dio. I don't know.
Okay. I'm going to pause this section here because he goes and pulls out a line from a song. Yeah, it all comes down to a line in a song. But I'm trying to find some financial talk so you guys can hear him talk. And you tell me, is this drugged out? I mean, whatever, black and dyed, sideburn Elvis Presley wannabe, dirty haired guy sound like a professional to you? Not to me, anyways. Let's listen up.
Lay out a scenario, which I firmly believe in, where the greatest transfer of wealth the world has ever seen is underway. Now, how can I back that up? Several ways. Number one is this. Look at the bull run in gold. Gold has been in a 12-year bull run. Look at the value of the dollar, okay? Since the inception of central banking here in the United States in 1913, the dollar has lost 98% of its value. Think about what that means. That means that a dollar today is worth 2 cents of what it would have been worth at the inception of the central banking system. And this transfer of wealth is getting more and more profound and is accelerating, something I've been talking about for a very, very long time. These are the kings and queens I'm referring to out of Ronnie James Dio's quote. The rest of the people, all of us, are being enslaved, we're being controlled, we're being manipulated, we're being lied to.
Well, he's right about that. We're being lied to. So it's the same old song and dance, and I don't know how long you've been watching him, but you know, if you've been watching him for a while, you may have noticed, you know, this is date captured here. It's the same shit show that he's been singing for the longest time. And it's always, you know, the criminal globalist banking cartel, go run out there and buy your gold and silver, because while the collapse is on, the game is rigged, and how to profit from the coming collapse, well, you got to listen to Gregory Mannarino. I don't think so. Greg is so busted, he doesn't even, like I said, the pale-faced drug addict user, or actually, we shouldn't even say that, because maybe he doesn't do drugs. Maybe he's just, I don't know, he's satanic. No, I'm not sure what's wrong with him, but there's something wrong with him. He's lack of color. I mean, even I don't go outside that often, but at least I got some color on me. So let's go back here, because what's important is, as I said, Taco came in here and tried to hide the evidence, this son of a bee. But first, before hiding it, I can see what someone wrote in the comments here. Jason Caldwell says, this is some real truth. Why don't you have a lot more subs? Because as I said, Jason, we're censored here. They don't want you guys catching in. They're going to make sure you're not going to get my live show. This is why I've said 100 times, come and join me at the forum. But you think you guys will listen? No. You'll stick around on YouTube. It's, you know, and I've noticed this. Hey, I've been doing YouTube since 2009. You guys are stubborn as hell. I can tell you 20,000 times, you're not going to get your notifications at one point. There's no sense bothering to subscribe. Well, even though I still think you should, I'm telling you right now, YouTube censors the notifications. Join me at connectingdotsone.com. It's fucking pointless. Pointless. You guys don't get it. So keep waiting there for the videos. I hope it shows up. Okay. Anyways, sorry. I'm not upset, but I've been doing this for years and you guys don't seem to catch on. In fact, here's the really sad part. A lot of you guys just listen for the financial stuff and you don't give a shit about censorship or, you know, or people losing their lives over a fraud or anything like that. That's so sad. You know, I give out free information. I try to help people. And just go listen to this one here, this Fukushima wager. $3,000 I'm waging this guy who took someone's, well, he didn't take someone's life, but he defrauded somebody who ended up taking their life over the whole damn thing. And I can't even get people to even go do that simple thing, what I'm asking to do in that video. So you have to understand it at points. Don't understand why I'm not always willing to help and go the extra mile all the time, because honestly, I see a lot of people that are not willing to even put in any effort at all in stuff. So, and I mean, simple things like just watching the damn Fukushima $3,000 video I just pointed out and go ramming it down that guy's comment section so he can take me up on that $3,000 bet. Come on, it's summer 2015. I need some holiday money. Plus, I'll give you $50 if he takes me up on the offer. Anyways, again, here I had this screen capture. And if you don't know what screen capture, well, it's this little tool here that's supplied by Microsoft. You can see it right here in the middle of my screen, snipping tool. So I use this little tool whenever I come across great evidence, and I can trace a little circle around it. And then all of a sudden, I got all the evidence there, and I have the use of a pen where I can go track things down. So that comment that you're looking at the screen, comes from Taco, the leader, the censor, the guy who was busting Gregory Mannarino. And all of a sudden, when someone speaks out, the honest Jew, oh, well, he has to go hide the evidence. But first, before hiding it, let's listen what Taco has to say. He says, well, I can't speak to what, by the way, he doesn't speak like that. By the way, Taco, I can't speak or understand what you're saying, but I can't, you know, I'm going to speak like him. It's going to be annoying as hell. Well, I can't speak to what you are saying and what conversations you may or may have not had with Mithristatis, but I will say this for Bear Stearns. They only hire Ivy League top business eco degree schools. Even Tacos couldn't get hired. And mind you, I have worked for top wire houses, started out as a stockbroker trainee, but then I moved into compliance, and I have even written up rules and regulations for investment firms' protocols. I have background in compliance or secure and or security laws. Holy jumping. Business law. I also have once worked for FINRA, so I have a long 20 years background in the finance industry. I'm telling you, folks, I'm not recommending you go listen to this Taco Guys network, but if you do, I'm almost 100% sure that the very first video that you listen to this clown, although he on when you're reading that, he may sound, well, no, he said he worked all those, he didn't work no 20 years. I think he's probably a 30-year-old guy. I don't even think he's, 40 years old. There's no way he could have done all of those. But what's best, if you actually listen to his voice, you'll quickly realize that, hey, it's me, Taco, the guy who wanna listen.
I'm Greg Hunter. Welcome to the USA Watchdog YouTube channel. It supports USAWatchdog.com. I'm a former investigative correspondent. I worked on ABC's Good Morning America and also on CNN on many of their platforms. I try to put out interviews and information that is above all accurate. As my slogan on the website says, I try to give you a clear picture of what's really going on. I hope you enjoy the channel. And I hope you subscribe. Thanks again. I'm Greg Hunter. Hello, I'm Greg Hunter. Thank you for joining us today on USAWatchdog.com. I'm bringing back Greg Mannarino. He was a big hit. He got 20,000 plus, views on the YouTube channel. He's the former Bear Stearns floor trader in the early to mid 90s. He shucked all that. He goes to the medical profession. He's a physician's assistant now, but he's still dabbling with finances and actually doing a little consulting work on the side. He also has a book that has been pre-released here called The Politics of Money. You can see it right here. It'll be out full force in a few weeks, but you can get it right now on lulu.com. Joining me now, Greg Mannarino. Greg, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me, Greg. Thank you.
Well, Greg, you hear a lot of talk about, what you could invest in as a hedge at a brokerage. And, my thought here is, it doesn't matter if you have a good investment if your brokerage turns into PFG Best or MF Global or Sentinel. And there was a big case with Sentinel that is a big ruling that came out, actually an appeal ruling. That said that, brokerage can, pledge your money, use it as collateral, and then if they blow up or when they blow up, you are no longer first in line for your own money. What are your thoughts on this? This is pretty scary.
It's very scary, Greg. What is safe? What is safe now? I mean, we're referring to here was the issue with central management and New York Bank Mellon with the segregated funds, which were actually mutual funds. Most people have mutual funds. Well, a segregated fund, that specific one, was a mutual fund linked to a life insurance policy. I mean, these are considered safe havens. And anyone that's an investor or into finance understands that. These investment vehicles are considered, well, I wouldn't say like gold, but kind of like gold. In other words, they're there for when you need them. It's unbelievable what the court ruled. They said that exactly what you said. This is not your money. These institutions can now use these accounts as collateral against, well, I guess whatever they want to. And if it disappears, well, guess what? You're in trouble.
So you're acting as a consultant right now. What are you telling, you know, your corporate clients that you're consulting for? How are you telling them to shield their wealth?
Okay. You know, it's crazy to think that institutions, and I'm talking about big institutions, don't really have a clear picture of where we're going in the future here. And a lot of them are of the belief that things are going to be okay. So they have a lot of high-risk investments. Now, this goes back to the individual person as well. What used to work in the past is not going to work in the future. Period, the end. It's a whole new set of rules.
So what is not going to work in the future? I mean, Mario Draghi with the ECB has said we're going to have unlimited bond buying. I mean, they're going to turn on the spigots. People like Jim Sinclair says, hey, we've got a full-blown global money bomb going on with all the central banks, Japan, ECB, Treasury. What's not going to work in the future?
None of it's going to work. Why is that? Well, it's very simple. It really is, and that's what I'm all about. I like to break everything down to what does it really mean? We have to understand, people need to understand, a new monetary system is already in the works. People are talking about it. And this paper, it comes down to the fact that the paper scheme is over. We are now at the end of the ability to add any more debt on. We're done. But what are they doing? They're trying to continue and prop it up by adding more debt. Now, what you just brought up with Mario Draghi and this whole issue in Europe, what they're going to do, or what they're talking about doing, whether it actually happens, who knows? They are going to start a bond buying program involving monies that are already in circulation. In other words, they're not going to do what Ben is doing and just print it out of thin air. And people are kind of cheering about it. And it does have a plus side and it has a minus side. I guess the plus side is, okay, he's saying we're not going to print money out of thin air, but where's the interest coming from? That's what I want to know. I think they're going to have to print. Of course they're going to have to. There's no way out of them not printing. That is what's going on. It's something, again, that many people are covering is we're now going to start seeing more and more printing at an epic scale. We understand. The Federal Reserve just came out and said, hey, you know, we're going to be ready to ease. Of course, they have no choice but to ease. Ease. I hate that word, ease. What does that mean? It means we're going to print money. We're going to buy assets with it. Why can't they just say what it is? Why do they have to say, we're going to ease? Like it's going to make our lives better? Of course it's not going to make our lives better. What is it going to do? It's going to cause inflation. And not only is it going to cause inflation, it's causing fear. Fear. Investors are starting to say, hey, what's going on here? I have all this money locked up in dollars that are being literally and deliberately punished to the point of ridiculousness. And they're going to start dumping them. Concept I've been over for a very long time. And I think this QE3 is going to backfire. I can't imagine a way that it would actually work. It's going to devalue the currency. Let's talk. It's done it time and time again. How much of this are people going to take? I don't know. The investors are already dumping their dollars. There's no doubt about it. I always tell people, watch the money velocity. Once the money velocity starts kicking up, they're going to spin that as being a good thing. It's not going to be a good thing. When the money velocity moves, that means people are dumping dollars. And it's going to happen. And what's going to happen to all those dollars that are being dumped or used? They're going to come right back here to the United States. And we're going to see inflation that people are not going to believe. That's the way it's going to play out.
Aren't they really doing this to prop up the banks? I mean, so many people, John Williams, people like Jim Sinclair, they just say they're just propping up the banking system. Aren't the banks still in big trouble?
Yes, a lot of the major banks are in big trouble. I have some charts here I can show you if you'd like to go over them.
Sure. I mean, I've heard rumors about and from several sources that for one bank's in trouble is Morgan Stanley. Show me what's going on with the banks. I mean, what do you think? Are some of the big banks in big trouble?
They are in big trouble. And, you know, before I actually get to those charts, let me just go over this. What they're doing, once again, because it worked last time, is a consolidation of power. We lost Bear Stearns. We lost Lehman Brothers last time. It was just all that was consolidation of power. And they're doing it again. Let's go over some of these charts real quick. This is Morgan Stanley. Now, understand, a company's stock is reflective of its business model, right? Okay, so let's have a look at this. This is going back to 2005 until last week. Let's have a look. What do you think of that?
Oh, boy. $90 to $15.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. I don't want to own this. How
about
this? Here's Deutsche Bank.
160, 34, done.
Done. How about HSBC?
144.
Okay.
Take a fork in them.
Yes, I'm going to show you the scariest chart of them all. This is a chart of the U.S. dollar, Greg. This is going back till 2002.
Boy. If the dollar was representative of a share of the U.S., Inc., it looks like we're in trouble, just like the banks. Am I wrong?
Oh, it's over. It just goes back to what I've been saying. We are now in a transition period, Greg, and that transition period is going to be not good for some, and it is going to be good for others. And this is why I always say, become your own central bank. Do what the central banks are doing, and you're going to be okay. If you do not, if you choose to stay in a currency that is plummeting, what is that going to do to your purchasing power? How are you going to be able to support yourself? It's going to, and this is just the beginning. This is just the beginning.
Now, you're not talking about buying GLD or SLV, some exchange-traded fund. You're talking about taking direct control of silver, gold, platinum, farm ground, diamonds, artwork, getting your car title, making sure you're out of debt. Is that what you're talking about?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think getting out of debt is a main theme in my book, The Politics of Money. In fact, I wrote a whole few chapters on getting out of debt and how to do it. You know, forget about these these TV commercials, they just want to steal your money. I told you how to do it in that book, the most easiest and most simple way, step by step, by the way. It's not good.
Well, coming up, what are you telling your clients to do? I mean, if the brokerage, you're saying the brokerages, at least some of them, can't be safe. I mean, Morgan Stanley's brokers is Smith Barney. Bank of America has a brokerage. HSBC has a brokerage. I imagine Bank of America's a stock chart looks about the same as the other ones, you know, going straight down.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
What are you telling people who may have accounts at any of those banks or brokerages?
I think the first thing to consider is this, and this is a fact. These institutions that I just showed you, they're insolvent. They're insolvent. I don't care what's on their balance sheets because they're all leveraged to the hilt. They're leveraged in so many different ways. And they have no money. What does that mean for the people, Greg? That means that the people in these banks that have their money in these banks or their cash, they're broke too. They're insolvent as well.
Do you think they're going to be put on the sacrificial financial altar and off with their heads and their assets are going to go to the J.P. Morgans and Goldman Sachs? And is that what you're telling me?
Yes, I do. Let's look at this chart. This is J.P. Morgan. They've been pretty much flat the entire time going back 2005. I can show you the same chart with Goldman Sachs. They've pretty much been flat as well. There's going to be a consolidation of power here. It's already being set up. And I'll tell you something that I find kind of interesting lately. If you follow the mainstream media channels, you see they're hyping the financial stocks. Forget about the hype. You always got to get, you know, the successful investor is the one that gets in on the opposite side of the trade. Doesn't follow the pack. You understand? If people are bullish, you're bearish. If people are bearish, you're bullish. This is my investing philosophy. Get in on the opposite side of the trade, and you will do better in the long run. You know, that's just a little secret that I like to give out. But it's the truth. This is how successful investors work. They don't follow the pack. They do the opposite of what the pack does, and they do better in the long run.
So you think, based on your chart work, that the rumors about Morgan Stanley being in some trouble, you think there may be truth to that reflected in their stock price?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. All of them. It's absolutely reflected in their stock price. That is telling you how their business model is working. And, you know, I'm a chart guy. I look at charts every day. In fact, I go blind looking at charts every day. But absolutely, yes. Again, it goes back to your theme. I believe there is going to be a consolidation of power, just like there was with the crash of 2008 when we lost Lehman Brothers and we lost Bear Stearns. We know how that played out. All it did was make the too big to fails even bigger. And now they're going to get even bigger. The scheme worked before. It is going to work again. The people are going to be slaughtered who are not ready for this. That's it.
And you think that if you are an account holder, and particularly at one of their brokerages, that if their money is likely going to get pledged or used as collateral, and if and when they do go under, and who knows who, but some of those stock charts look pretty scary, if and when they do go under, what do you think the chances of them getting their money back?
Zero. Absolute zero. I mean, look what happened. Look at the court ruling. They're setting this up, Greg. They're setting up the I don't know what you want to call it, grand theft, or on an unimaginable scale. And the middle class is going to be gone in a few years. There's going to be a ruling class and the serfs, and this is part of their process. That's exactly how I see this playing out.
Gregory Mannarino, The Politics of Money. It's pre-released on Lulu, LULU.com. Greg, thanks for coming on to USAWatchdog.com.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, David, how's the acid? That coke from the end of your nose. Now David's going to model his beautiful outfit.
Hi, I'm Greg Hunter. Thank you for joining us today on USAWatchdog.com. We have back a favorite of mine and of our audience here on USA Watchdog, Greg Mannarino. Of course, he's a former floor trader. He came out with a book called The Politics of Money recently. He's written 6 or 7 books. This book is number 62 on Lulu.com. It comes out in wider release in a few days. Greg Mannarino, thank you for joining us here on USAWatchdog.com.
Greg, it's always a pleasure. Thanks for having me again. I really appreciate it.
Well, you know, one thing I left off, you know, you have GregMannarino.com. You have your YouTube channel, almost 1 million views. Haven't been on it that long. Let's jump right into the fire here and start off with these numbers they came out recently. It just seems like all the numbers are bogus. You know, the unemployment numbers and now the GDP numbers. 1.15% is the nominal GDP number. People like John Williams at ShadowStats.com say, well, if you take a look at the seasonal factors and, adjusted for inflation, probably that's what drove most of the 1.15% growth. What do you say?
I don't think we're growing at all. I think we're contracting. I think this is all a farce. I always refer back to the money velocity. We're beyond historic lows at this particular point. We've never seen numbers this low before, ever in history, and they're getting worse. That's a frightening prospect, because without money, cash, changing hands, you can't have any growth. And something I've been over many, many times in my particular videos and my blog is when we do see the money velocity move, it doesn't mean things are getting better, Greg. I believe that when we start to see that, that means people are rushing faster out of the dollar than they already are. We know for a fact that the dollar now, well, in my view, is in a terminal phase. As a matter of fact, I made a chart for you and for your listeners. Let's have a look at this.
I love your charts, buddy.
This chart is very frightening to me. This is from 2002 until today, right up to date. Here's the U.S. dollar. What do you think of this, Greg?
A little bottom bouncing the last couple of years, but it doesn't look good.
It looks awful. I just hate this chart. And this today, as a matter of fact, we're seeing a rally. Well, the past couple of days, a little rally here in the markets for a lot of reasons. But one is because the dollar is losing value against the euro. So everything becomes more expensive, even shares of stock. It's just an awful situation that we're in here, Greg. And, they're going to prop it up. They're going to twist it. And they're going to spin it every way possible. But that's where we have you, to let us all see the truth.
Well, you do. Ben Bernanke was out defending his, $40 billion a month buying mortgage-backed securities, which I keep saying that, these are the mistakes of bankers that was supposed to be equal to a treasury. Surprise, they're not. And then the Operation Twist, $45 billion. And after that, we're going to continue to basically print money. And something that you came out and said to me on the phone as I was setting up this interview is, bet against debt. Tell me about your bet against debt. Debt theory.
All right. Well, what do we know? Well, the dollar chart that I just showed you, the dollar represents debt. It does not represent wealth at all. We understand that the debt bubble is being fueled, just like you said, it's out of control. We have over 1,000 million a day at this time being printed out of thin air. That's for this mortgage-backed security scheme that the Federal Reserve is doing right now. But think about this. At the end of this year, we understand that this extension of Operation Twist is ending. What else do we know? We know that Ben has come out and said, hey, we are going to keep interest rates low through 2015. How does he do that, Greg? Well, let's think about it. He has to get into the market. He can't just say it. Ben is not magical. So how does he do that? He has to buy bonds. He's literally telling us that at the end of this year, he's going to do QE4, which is going to be, in my opinion, an in-our-face bond buying purchasing program, I think biggest we've ever seen yet. And that's the big print. So what's happening?
The big print? Hold on. Let me breathe. Let that breathe. That's the big print?
The big print.
Money printing. You got it. I love that.
Yeah. We understand what's going on here. The central banks of the world have become printing presses. And because of that, they're creating more issues regarding debt. It's unbelievable. Now, this is another chart I made for you guys out there and you. This is a 30-year bond here. This is ugly. Clear bubble. This isn't a bubble. Now, this bubble, along with every other bubble, will burst. Let me give you another example of a bubble here. This is the Dow. This is another bubble just prior to the crash in 2008. You can see the pattern there. Very, very similar pattern here. It's incredible. Now, if we understand there is being an epic bubble being created with regard to debt. This is the sovereign debt in the United States. Look at that bubble.
Oh, that's in your book.
That's my book, yeah.
That's parabolic.
It's terrifying. So what we want to do is bet against that debt. And how do we do that? Well, we realize that debt, currency is debt. We don't want to hold currency. We want to get away from this. And
How do we protect ourselves? How do we bet against that? How do we take the short end against this debt and have the ultimate, literally, hedge? That is simply this. Get yourself into gold. Get yourself into silver, physical in-your-hand assets. What we're really doing, Greg, and people don't understand this, but it's an interesting concept, is by holding precious metals, we're really taking the short end of the trade against debt. Now, my trading philosophy for very many years has been to bet opposite of the crowd. I don't follow the crowds when I'm looking to invest here. I always look for a way to get on the opposite end, because fear creates more wealth than greed does. And this is a proven fact throughout time. So what we're doing is betting against that debt by holding real assets, gold and silver in this particular case I'm discussing. And because of that, we're going to be setting ourselves up for a major win as we move forward, because currency is dying. The debt-based economic model that is the system that the modern world is following, it's over. It's dead. A new monetary system is coming, and we need to protect ourselves.
One of the things, about your, bet against debt is also bet against bonds, which are really currency instruments, bonds. And I got some smart people on the site. One of the guys that comments is a guy, he goes by the handle Man About Dallas. And really smart people. I don't know why they come on the site to get information from me. Some of these people are brilliant. And I've been screaming about how people like, Ray Dalio is the biggest bond fund, $120 billion. And, John Paulson, who bet against, the housing bubble, made billions of dollars. And then Bill Gross, he is nicknamed the Bond King. He's nicknamed the Bond King. This guy made billions of dollars in the bond market. PIMCO, that's what he founded and sits atop of, has $1.3 trillion under management. He's on Bloomberg. He's writing posts on PIMCO's website. He is on other channels saying that you should buy gold and you need a commodity that, I think he's wrong about the commodity part, but he's saying you need something that you can't be easily duplicated, like dollars. And this guy, Man About Dallas, comes in, and I've been screaming about how important this is. This guy is saying, buy gold, buy silver, buy tangibles. And the Man About Dallas guy says, that's such an unbelievable signpost, mile marker. It's kind of like the Pope saying, well, this Christianity thing we've been doing for the last couple of thousand years? We should really look into doing some Buddha stuff now, too. It's an unbelievable turn of events for a guy nicknamed the Bond King telling people on the company website, on television business channels to buy precious metals, buy, hard assets. And he's talking about buying gold.
Yes. Bill Gross is a smart guy, and he understands the bonds are in a bubble.
Yes.
And you got to bet against it. What people don't realize, I think, by and large, Greg, is every single, and there's never been an exception to this rule, ever, every single bubble, economic and financial bubble, has to burst, and they all will burst. They have all burst throughout history because they rise above a level that can be sustained by any means, something I go over at length in my book here, The Politics of Money. It cannot be sustained indefinitely. So it brings us full circle, bet against the debt, just like you just said. That's what Bill Gross is telling us. The man is very smart. He knows what he's talking about. Bet against the bonds, which is debt. Bet against currency, which is debt, and you will come out of this good. If you're one of those out there who believes that pieces of paper with numbers printed on them represent anything real, you got problems. And that's why I'm on this mission, to make people realize that this whole entire thing is a farce. It is coming apart, and many people are going to suffer because of that, but some, if they take the advice of someone like Bill Gross, they're going to do very, very well. We've never witnessed anything like this before, Greg, in the history of the world. Never
once. Yeah, this is big. Yeah. Does it make any difference who's, last night with the debates, Obama, Romney, does it make any difference who the president is in 2013? Does it make a difference?
No, it doesn't make a difference. I always say Wall Street runs the world, And our votes, unfortunately, don't matter. They, in my opinion, they've already picked the next president. It doesn't matter. He's just a spokesperson for Wall Street. The policymakers, in collusion with the central banks, the investment banks, they run the world. And actually, it's more simple than that. It's the investment banks and the Federal Reserve. They run the world. The policymakers, they take a back seat. And they do, they're being puppetized. Puppetized.
Final question. Are gold and silver in a bubble?
In no way. In no way, shape, or form are they
Why?
In a bubble. Well, first of all, they're not widely held assets. For something to be in a bubble, it has to be widely held. Very few people actually hold this asset. 10%? Something like that. I've heard varying numbers.
That'd be a lot, 10%. 1 out of 10, I'd say less than that.
Probably less than that, right? But it's a fraction of the people as a whole. What I do believe is going to happen is we're going to see a mania in metals. And it's going to look like a bubble, but it's not going to actually be a bubble. But there will become a time when we need to reallocate funds out of our metals. But that's not for a long, long way off. I mean, I put price targets on this stuff in my book, when we're going to need to reallocate our funds into distressed assets. And again, that's when this bubble bursts. And we're pretty close to it. We're pretty close at this time. I really believe that if we follow this trajectory we're on, we could literally be months away, months away.
Greg Mannarino, GregMannarino.com. Thank you for joining us on USAWatchdog.com.
Thanks, Greg.
I'm Greg Hunter. Welcome to USAWatchdog.com. With us, a regular guest, one of the guys I have on more than probably anybody else. He's a personal friend of mine, and I can always tell when I need to have him on when I start getting pinged and then people say, hey, get on Gregory Mannarino or TradersChoice.net. And, of course, that's who we got on. Greg Squared today. Gregory Mannarino, thanks for joining us today on USAWatchdog.com.
It is great to be here, Greg. Thanks for having me back.
You sent me a chart. I want to get to that in a minute because I want to kind of build to what the chart means and what your analysis is of the chart. Because in the pre-interview, we talked about this. First thing I want to talk about is gold. You are a big gold proponent, silver proponent as well, too. But we don't talk much about it. And just recently got a big, big pop up here, about almost 20 bucks in a day. What are you, what's your read on gold being now approaching $1,300 an ounce?
Greg, we ain't seen nothing yet. That's what I have to say with regard to the price action of precious metals here. Look, I think the easiest way to put this into a context for people to understand is the global debt issue that you and I have spoken about, I don't even know how many times, is going to get not just worse, Greg, but monumentally worse, especially in light of the geopolitical landscape, in light of the fact that world central banks have no alternative, none, and I mean zero, other than to continue to inflate and inflate and inflate. It's just so easy to understand why you need to be in hard assets right now, in an alternative currency, because again, they have no alternative. So get on the opposite side of that trade, something I've been talking about forever. These assets have nowhere to go, nowhere to go but higher, and I mean higher, Greg.
Is this what the rush into gold is? Is that little people? Is that somebody going down to your local coin store and buying an ounce of gold? Give me a couple of silver eagles. Give me a half ounce of gold. Or is this institutional players driving it up, 18, 20 bucks in a day?